What's up guys? Today I'm gonna just show you a really quick video on how to remove the wind deflector on the e89. I thought this was gonna be quite straightforward, but as it turned out, I hit a snag on the way. Managed to solve it, but I'm just gonna show you how it's done. So as you can see here, the wind deflector here is just it's sort of spring loaded, so just you push it down and outwards and just get it out of the way. Afterwards, you have this one here. I'll show you as an example. Here are the pins. These are the only ones that keep this one in place, sort of. Well, that's what I thought originally. But as I started to pry it out, it was stuck on one side. And there you have this thing right here. So I'm just gonna show you how to get rid of that one, because that's sort of the issue. All right, so what you need to do is first of all remove these to gain access to the screws beneath them, and I'm just gonna be using a flat head here and try not to be too over hard with the rubber thingy here that hides the screw. Right, there we go, one down. Right, so there we go. And just remove these. There we go. And you're done. Okay, so here we have the finished result. Nothing to it, just reverse mount it. No issues there. Now, a point of advice. I started off with wrapping these in like a high gloss vinyl. And the angles of them are quite, they're quite challenging. So if you're not very experienced or good at wrapping stuff, I would recommend plastidipping, because that's what I did. I started off with one doing the wrap, and the wrap just it shrunk back, so you had some gaps and stuff, so I didn't manage to do it quite well. So instead I just ended up plastidipping and ended up with doing some glossifier on some matte black paint. And this is the result. I think it's quite decent. It's not flawless, of course, but it looks good from like half a meter away or something. So quite satisfied with this. There you go. And also, if in case you're wondering, the difference between with or without a wind deflector is massive. If you're thinking about buying one, absolutely do it. There's you're gonna be way more comfortable. Being without one for like a week during the wrapping process and painting process, I actually was surprised how big a difference it did or made. So again, if you're thinking about it, do it. I recommend it.